Hi children, welcome back. Okay, in the last video we have discussed a lot many things about the water and what are the characteristics of water, sources of water and even the importance of the water also. And then in this video we are going to continue with the importance, of course the importance of water we have done already. Then we are going to discuss deep about the sources of the water and even the storage of the water, and then we are going to discuss about at last the water cycle. See children, sources of water, as we have already learned in the last video, there are many sources of waters. Again, in that we have two types. One is natural source of water and another one is we can consider as the man-made or the artificial source of the water. Then in the natural source of the water we have ocean, river, lake, pond and the well, open wells and the bore wells or the pump pipe wells or pump wells we can say, and the springs we have and the falls we have, isn't it? So like this we can get many source of waters naturally. Then artificial source of waters, for example we have man-made tanks are there, cement tanks, syntex, we have tanks even in front of our house, upside of our house, that is syntex, and even in our field also. Okay, in our field also we have big tanks, we use that tanks to store the water, and we have some vessels to store the water in our houses also. Like that, those vessels are made up of the steel and the plastic, isn't it? But nowadays we have steel and plastic and even the cement tanks also. But in the previous ancient days they were not having any cement cement tanks and the plastic tanks and the fiber, syntex, buckets, they don't have. But those days they have the buckets and the vessels of made up of, and the big vessels made up of the brass and the copper, and even they had the buckets also, which again those are also made up of the metals, the brass and the copper. And compared to these plastic and steel vessels, those vessels are very much they were very much good for our health. If we store the water for one night or two nights in the copper vessel, that would be very helpful for our health. So there will be no acidity if we drink like that copper water from the copper vessel, and if we use that one for cooking, we will not get the acidity problems and other some germs if are there in our body, that water is going to kill that germs. And if we drink that water regularly, so we are going to avoid many types of diseases from our health. So this like how those all are, like that water is useful, because those days, ancient days, our grandfather, mother, we can see grandmother and grandfather, they have very less health issues because they were following the life routine which was very healthy. But nowadays we have life routine which is unhealthy, properly, completely unhealthy. We eat food which is contaminated a lot, we eat, drink water again which is contaminated a lot, we use plastics which is not at all good for our health. So then also we are continuing this one only. But those days our grandparents, they have very hygienic and very friendly things for our health, and they were very particular about their health. They were used to take the food and the water which is really pure and which is really helpful for their health, digestion and maintaining of their health. But nowadays we are eating, keeping in fridge, and we are eating for food for many days. It will be cooked off before 3 to 4 days and still we will be eating by keeping in the fridges. So by doing this one, we are going to lose our efficiency in our health. This is how the difference between the ancient our previous days, how our grandparents were there and how we are living right now. Okay, then storage of water, these were the simple vessels and simple things, that substances how we store the water. Then again, even if we can see a big tank in our street, the whole tank is going to store the water, and it will be supplied to the every house of that village or city. Okay, so like this we have artificial storage of water. And then natural source of water, as I told you, river. Okay, even for river also, from where the water is going to come, there will be a small spring like structure in the earth. Okay, from where the underground water will come with the through the spring, and that hole, from that hole the water is going to flow, and it will flow till some area, and again it will get the broader range to flow. That is how it will become the river. Okay, again the every river will flow towards the ocean. All the rivers will born in some particular place where they will get the underground water, which will come out of the earth, and which will flow starting very narrow, and after some area which is going to be flow in the broader way. Okay, that will form a bigger river. Okay, and the every river will flow towards the ocean. Then ocean is a collection of lot many of rivers which are coming from different places on this whole earth. Okay, so because of this we have lot of water in the ocean. And even of course in the river also we have the particular taste and particular characteristics of that water for a particular river. And lake, you might have seen, even the lake is also storage of the water from where the underground, from underground water is coming and standing there. And even the pond, compared to the lake and pond, both are same only. There will be a water collected will be there, but pond will be a smaller size compared to the lake. And then falls we have seen. See, if there is a heavy rain, or if the river is flowing, and in between of some place the river has got it is flowing on the hill, and it will flow and fall down. Okay, that scene is called as the falls, waterfalls. You might have seen many waterfalls which is really looks beautiful, especially in the rainy season. You might have visited many falls. Gokak Falls is there, and even the Jog Falls is there, you might have seen. Okay, then other than this, we have some area like in Himachal and all, we have lakes and ponds. We will be having those water very cold, very cold. And in some area, some point of area on this earth will be there. From there, the water will come with a lot of force outside, and that water is going to produce hot water. Water will be very much hot. Along with that hot water, it will produce lot of steam. Okay, that steam is again used for many purposes naturally. That one you will learn when you go for 9th and 10th standard. Okay, why that particular steam is used and what we can produce by using that steam. But this hot water will be there, and so like this waters we get from the hot spot area. A hot spot area means, see, you know that river is also one of the source of the water, but this river is upside the earth. And for river, from where the water is going to come, again the ground level or underground, from underground of the earth. So by this we can say that water is stored even on the earth also, and even under the earth also. Even how the water is flowing in the on the earth in the form of river and the lake and the ocean, how it is flowing, or in the how it is flowing in the pipes also, in the same way water flows even under the ground also. Then that water we say as the call as the underground water. Okay, so why it will be flowing? We know that the earth is not even, earth is inside, the earth is, it is made up of lot of rocks are there and soil is there, and the many different types of soils are there, different types of rocks are there. Then when the water is flowing under the ground, if suppose they get rocks, many rocks are, I mean a rock is there, then from that rock that water get lot of pressure. Okay, because the rocks will be very heavy compared to the soil and all. Then that, because of that heavy pressure, if there is a small opening just around the rock or in that area, then water will come with a lot of pressure. Lot of pressure, and even there will be some points where the lava and the magma will be very near to that underground water. Then because of that heat, this water will get lot of temperature and it will come just like a spring outside. Okay, then where it is there it can form a small pond, and that water will be very hot. So like this reason we get in the Himachal Pradesh and in the some area we call them as a hot spot springs, because there we get the hot water and the very hot steam, and that area will be especially a rocky area and very hard area, from where the underground water gets a lot of pressure on that, and with that, because of that pressure, it will come outside just like with a lot of pressure. Okay. This is how the sources of water are there on this our beautiful earth. Okay, and how the water is there on the land, even the same water is there inside or under the ground also. It will be also flowing. So because of that only we get water in the bore wells. And the well, you have seen well also. Then how the water is going to be stored in the well? Then again we have a small opening from the under the level of the ground of earth ground, and from there a small hole the continuous water will come upside because of the upside pressure. Then there will be a storage of water in the, we can build a well in the square shape or in the circle or in the cylindrical shape, then that water is going to be stored in that well. Then we can use that water for many purposes, for household uses also, for agriculture also, for animals also we can use. Then we are using and again new water is coming upside. Even the same thing happens in the river also. This is how the underground water will come upside, and which we will get the natural source of the water. See children, this is how we get the source of the water. These are the source of the water. Then how do we store the water? You know that nowadays we have a big tanks, syntex, barrels, vessels, plastic vessels, buckets, we can store the water. And if the water is needed for one whole street or one whole city, then the big cement tanks will be built and they will be stored bit upper, I mean bit higher than the ground level. Okay, so from there we can get water easily, which will flow in the pipes, and every house we can get the water through the pipes. Regularly they have made some timetable. In that particular day, in that particular time, we get the water from the big tank to the our houses, isn't it? And even in the field also we can build a big tanks, and we can build open tanks. Okay, even in the rain water also come and store there, isn't it? Even the flowing water also come and store there. We can build a big tank where the place is lower compared to the ground level. So like this we can store the water. As already we have discussed that water, the sources of water, and how the water flows, how the water is going to store, and how we can use the water. But have you ever wondered that how the water is going to become, or how water is going to come? My question is, what is the original source of the water? We are telling the river, ocean and all, but for river and ocean, even in the underground also, how the water will come? It is the main source of the water. Okay, the rain is main source of the water, and you have studied even the water cycle also, children. See, sunlight gives us lot of heat and sun rays. Because of the heat and sun rays, though sunlight and heat will fall on the surface of the water, that may be a small pond, big lake, ocean, river, whatever, your tank, whatever it may be, the sun rays will fall on the surface of the water and they will get heated. After some time, that heated water will get evaporate, isn't it? Then those steam, hot gas will go upside, and after some height it is going to form the clouds. When the clouds become very heavier, then they will pour again back to the ground because they cannot bear the heaviness. isn't it? They will form a small raindrops and it will start raining. Again, the water from the ground with the help of the sunlight, it will get evaporated. Again, after reaching some height, again they will form clouds and again it will fall in the form of raindrops. This is how this cycle will continue, this continuous cycle. Again from the earth, evaporated water, again from the clouds, raindrops, evaporated water, raindrop. This continues just like in the cycle. This is called as the water cycle. Then the main source of the water we get is, that is water cycle, and with the help of the rain. Okay. I hope you all have understood whatever we have discussed in this chapter, children, and after this video we can solve very easily the exercise part also. Okay. Then before ending this video, I would like to give you some homeworks. Okay. Write down what is water cycle, draw and write, draw, label the parts and write, or explain about that. What is the water cycle, draw and label its part and explain. You can do this one. And what are the sources of water, explain in brief. Okay, two questions I have given, and these are questions are very big. You have to explain very neatly. Then I hope you all are higher class students and you will do this work. Okay, I hope you will do this and enjoy this video also. Then in the next week we will come with the next different interesting topic. Okay, then till then, take care. Bye bye.